פרשת אמור, ספר ויקרא, נתיבות שלום, and the topic is מקראי קודש. וידבר השם אל משה לאמור, right? So השם is talking to משה, to speak to the בני ישראל, and you will tell them, right? ואמרת אליהם, מועדי השם אשר תקראו אותם, מקראי קודש, these are the time of the holidays that you should read them. These are the מקראי קודש, right? מקראי, it's like reading the holy things. אלה הם עודיי, these are my time, these are my holiday. ששת הימים תעשה מלאכה, ויום השביעי שבת שבתון, מקרא קודש, and so on. So six days you will work, or a work will be done, and in the seventh day, it will be like a resting day, a שבת שבתון, like an extra שבת שבתון, and it is מקרא קודש. Now it sounds simple for us, but you know, they're asking question here. יש לבים, we need to understand the meaning of why the Saturdays, the Shabbases, and the holidays, which called Moed, were called Mikra'e Kodesh. What is this Mikra'e Kodesh? Holy, we understand. Mikra'e is something that you call or read. So what is it, like reading or keeping this Kodesh? Valelechora, because it seems to be that there are mitzvot, right, commandment or rule or restrictions or law, like the other one that we have. What's the difference between that and putting tefillin, eating kosher food, not to eat non-kosher food, to do the Birkat HaLevana, etc.? Okay, that day, you're not allowed to do any melacha. And also you have, this is for Shabbos, and also you have other mitzvot that are significant or special for each and every day, every holiday, right, specifically. So why is it so significant or special that Shabbos, right, is called Mikrei Kodesh, or the other Yom Tov, Mikrei Kodesh, which is not like the other mitzvot in the Torah. V'chein, ma shayach chalut gedusha. What is the relation of the gedusha that is applied on that day, which is actually, there is nothing physically there on that day, right? It's a spiritual thing. Shabbat, we can understand, you know, it's the seventh day, but there are holidays that are they're coming on the date, right? So the Shabbat and the holiday, etc. So, and also, we're just talking about a day. So what is that day? What is so significant? Because the day is not something that you can touch. It's just a matter of timing. We can say more. והנה תפקידו ויהודו של כלל ישראל הוא, ואתם תהיו לממלכת כהנים וגוי קדוש. The purpose and our goal in life or the function that we playing of the nation of Israel is to be a nation of Goy Kadosh, right? A holy nation. Kman de Ketuv, it says in many places, right? In Sefer Dvarim, ki am kadosh ata l'Hashem Elokecha, you're a holy nation to your God. It means she'inyan ha-gedusha, the matter of the gedusha, it's not in the context or in a way that we are seeking for something to be proud of. It's not like we would like to be billionaires. We want to be holy because this is our essence. This is what we actually need to drive for. That's the essence of the nation of Israel. A holy nation, a holy, right? Goy Kadosh, the Am Kadosh, in a holy nation, right? Commander Ketuv, ואנשי קודש תיון לי, right? ולכאורה, but it's again, it's a question. How is it possible to have such kind of a reality of gedusha in the world, which is a physical materialistic world, full of desires, place of impurity and filth, and all the shell, and all the evil inclination, and the other side, and negative things. So in this world, how is it possible that the person, ימשיך האדם קדושה, will withdraw upon himself the Gidusha, to be holy in this world. Because Gidusha and this world are a contradiction. It's a contradiction. Gidusha is something spiritually, something that is divine. In this world, we all know what's going on in this world, especially today. Indeed, Hashem, right, the Kadosh Baruch Hu, God, bring down to this world a whole system of Gidusha. Right, it's a system, it's not only one thing. to be a Jew or to keep kosher, it's not like a diet that we're keeping, or we're keeping one mitzvah. It's a whole, it's an entire system. It's a Torah. You know the expression about when we say about something, oh, this is not a rocket science. To be a Jew is a billion times more than rocket science. Very, very complicated, seriously. Right? So Hashem brings to this world such kind of a system that when we have this system, then a Jew can actually hold to his purpose and to be a Goy Kadosh. And this system is actually, it's surrounding, it's the entire, right? To eat kosher, it's not a diet. Eat kosher is way of living. This is how we live our life. Not that we decided one day, okay, we're going not going to mix meat and milk together or to keep 6 hours, etc. This is our life. It's our life, simply. Simple thing is we breathe in and out. We need the oxygen. Same thing, we need to keep the Torah and mitzvah. There's no difference. It's the same thing. This is our life, right? The Torah Chaim. You choose life, right? Hashem said that in whatever verses that Hashem gave us the Torah, the mitzvot, and we need to choose between life and death. That's it. He said, so this type of system that Hashem brings down to this world, right? It's surrounding the whole world, which is the location, the place is the world. Shana, which is timing, and then nefesh, which is our soul. And in the world, in location, 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 right? The best location is the Beit HaMikdash, the temple in Yerushalayim. That the temple is bringing and flowing all the Kedusha and all the Shefa, the wealth and everything to the world, but especially for us, right? She Beit HaMikdash, right? And the Kodesh HaKodashim, they were mekachim, they were sanctified, the Klal Yisrael. And we know that a little bit of light pushing away darkness. And a little bit of Gedusha, of holiness, is rejecting and pushing away a lot of impurity. So that was the location of the Beit HaMikdash. V'chen b'shana, and what about the timing? All the good days, right? All the Yom Tovim, all the holiday and the Shabbos, right? The Saturday, they are again part of the system of the Gedusha. That anyone to be wants to be called or attach himself to the Kedusha. Yesh avro ma'ayanot. Ma'ayanot, it's a spring. It has springs of water. Divine, right? Kedusha, ma'ayanot of Kedusha. Kedaita barashit chokma, it says in the book, she'ashabbat is shoresh kol ha'kedushot, and we know when we daven every Shabbat, right? That me'en ha'brachot, that the Shabbat is the root of all the Kedushot. That's the main source. זה ביום מנדי כתב, וברך אלוקים את יום השבעי, והיקדש אותו, את השם blessed and sanctified the seventh day. It's the מעיין, it's the spring of קדושה for a Jew that wants to make himself holy. He should, you know, withdraw the קדושה, pump the water, the holy water of the קדושה from the Shabbat Kodesh. והוא היה, right? And this is the same thing of the ימים טובים, of all the holidays, all the Yom Tov. And that's why they called מקראי קודש. Because there are all springs of Kedusha surrounding the entire year, right? So we learn, for example, Rosh Hashanah we crowning Hashem, Yom Kippur it's Judgment Day, Sukkot is the victory, Shmini Atzeret is for the mind, and then we have other Yamim Tovim, right? Which are, or for example, we have the Shabbat Agadol, which is for Pesach, we just have it, it's giving us the strength for the next 6 months. And then we have Shabbat Shuva, giving us the strength for the 6 months until Shabbat HaGadol. It's all cycle, it's all timing. And Shabbat we have every 6 days. And every 4 weeks we have the Rosh Chodesh. And every year we have Rosh Hashanah, right? So it's all surrounding us. This is the system to bring us into that purpose of Kedusha. וכי אמר מרן הקדוש מקובן זכותו הגנו על השבת קודש, so he said about the Shabbat Kodesh, שהתחילה, that this is actually the head, the beginning of the מקרא קודש, and anyone wants to be called to the Kedusha should start from Shabbos Kodesh. That's the main source, main thing. והוא הדין, it's the same applicable to all the good days, right? All the ימים טובים that we have. So now we have the third one, which is the nefesh, right? The third part of the system. ואמר הכתוב, התקדשתם אתם קדושים, right? That you should be holy. And again, the one of the translation to the word holy is separated. You should be separated and you become separated. Hashem is separated, Hashem is one. We need to be separated too, to be like Hashem. ואמרו חזל, and I said, you said, מסכת יומא, אדם מקדש עצמו מלמדה. So when somebody is מקדש עצמו, making himself holy, separated here, attach himself to the Kedusha here in this world. In heaven, they were doing the same thing for him. Adam Mekadesh Atzmo Me'at, if somebody do a small step, right? You know, who said that?
Small Neil step. Armstrong.
Neil Armstrong, right? It's a small step to a person, right? To the small person.
Mankind.
Right? A big leap or a giant leap to humanity, right? So the same thing here. We do a small step here in the right direction to be close to Hashem, to do Kedusha, and from heaven they will pour on us Kedusha. We need to do the first step. And he said, and this is a complete system, a perfect system of Kedusha in the world, which is the location, Shana, which is the timing, and Nefesh, which is our soul, the spiritual thing, that Hashem brings down to here to this world, to anyone that wants to be Kadosh, anyone wants to be called. However, Omnam Lasagata Kedusha, צריך להקדים בתחילה. So how do we do that? So now he's giving us tools. Many times it's difficult. Yeah, we know what is wrong. We know what we need to fix. The big question is how we do that. So here we said, okay, how we do that? First, we need to detach ourselves from the bad things, and only after that we can start and do good things. Because he says, as long as the person is into the impurity and is sinking to the chomri, the gashmi, the physical, the desire that he have and the lust, then an impure cannot attach itself to the pure and the holy one, right? The en gedushat shabbatot ve'avim tovim v'chol asher techolav. How the gedusha, the spiritual light of Shabbat, can apply on a person that is still doing bad things? It cannot. So first, he need to purify himself from the tumah. To detach, right? Like what the Rambam is saying, that we need to accept on ourselves. First is a vidui, to admit that we did something wrong. Then to accept on ourselves not to do it ever again. And then when we are detaching ourselves from the bad thing, then we can start and do the good thing. And then we can actually get receiving the Kedusha. The Zohinyan, it is a person need to impurify himself in the regular. That's why, again, Hashem gave us three period of time that the person can really do a real job, a work on himself. And he's doing it a lot, right? In Pesach, in Shavuot, in Rosh Hashanah, right? In Sukkot, right? Shetuchul alav gedushat ha-chag. But in order for the gedusha of the chag to be applied on him, he needs to impurify himself from the tumah, from the impurity, before the regel. He needs to prepare. And also before the Shabbos Kodesh, he did tzich letayer atzomer tumah. And you need to also purify himself from the tumah, right? And this is the reason shemay tamah tovlim be'erev Shabbat. That's why many people go to the mikveh before Shabbos. Mikveh again, it's water, but it's more of a spiritual cleansing. V'zeh gam inyan ma'amar ha'bal shem tov ha'kadosh. That's what he said. We learned it many times. Our sages said that somebody that die in erev Shabbos, right before Shabbos, it's a good sign for him. So on the Kabbalistic part, on the why is it so good for somebody to be buried before Shabbos? Because there is something that called chibut hakever, that before the angel take the soul of a person, or before they can take the soul from the body, after they burying him, the two angels, very scary angels, they're coming and they making the grave a little bit wider. And then they can start, and you ever saw how people are cleaning a rug, right? You spread the rug and you hit it with this special broom. This is what they do to the neshama. So the more a person is attached to the physical, to the materialistic thing in this world, the soul have more difficulties to leave the body. So that's why I said here, it's a good sign for a person to die in every Shabbos, because this process has been saved from him. He doesn't need this process. The angel do not come and beating him in the grave. So that's on the basic explanation. But what the Baal Shem Tov actually wants to tell us, that not that the person literally die on Erev Shabbos, but before Shabbos, the person should pretend that he is dead and is shaking off all the gashmiut, all the materialistic, and all the desire that he have for this world. This is how we can go actually into Shabbos Kodesh, because it's a spiritual day. So do not think about work. If you have like some kind of a task that you have to do even on Matzei Shabbos, don't think about it during Shabbos. Try to detach yourself. This is what Baal Shem Tov say. Everything you can do and work during the weekday on Shabbat, don't think about it. If somebody can actually do that, it's a nice sign for him. It's a good thing. Because as long as we are attach ourselves to the Gashmiut, to the Chomriut, and to this world, then the Kedusha cannot apply on us. Lechen Bet HaMikdash. And so that was about the timing. And the Bet HaMikdash, which is the location, the Bet HaMikdash bring the Shefa, the Kedusha, and everything to the nation. Then we just needed to go there, right? To bring the sacrifices and everything. And just being there, it was purifying us. As a spiritual purifying. As our sages said, right? Because why? Because even if a person doesn't bring a sacrifice, we had constantly sacrifice of the dawn, of the morning, and sacrifice of the evening, of the night. And that was, again, for kapara, for an atonement, for the sins of the night, sins of the day. So even if somebody doesn't bring a sacrifice, still, there is a korbanot sibu, right? The general korbanot. So now we're going back to the to this time. This is all the preparation before the holiday that we have. That when a Jew is purifying himself before the regal, from all the physical thing and the materialistic thing that he's thinking, that's appropriate preparation for the Yom Tov, for the holiday. So then that holiday become a Mikra Kodesh. And then he can be able to reach, to arrive to the destination or to his purpose of Atem Tiuli Mamlechet Konim Goy Kadosh. Ve'anshe Kodesh Tiuli, holy people. Right? Kemama Aral Mor Shaddai, Zichato Agenenu. So all the Shabbos and the date of, right, we keep repeating, It's a commemorating Egypt, commemorating the redemption from Egypt. Why? But it's not only the commemorating the redemption from Egypt that we had 3,700 years ago. It's the redemption from Egypt that we have now. If you before Shabbos or before the holiday can say, okay, I have so much work to do. I'm going to detach myself. The work will wait for me. I'm going to think and concentrate about the mitzvah, about the chag and everything. Very difficult to do it. It's very difficult because it always sits here about something that we need, you know, like a bug, like a mosquito. But he said, but the Jew needs to remember that he needs to shake off from the Maaseh Eretz Mitzrayim, from the thing that is stressing us. And that will help us to go into the Kedusha. He says, and this is also the preparation to the holiest day that we have, which is Chag HaShavuot, that is coming soon, right? Yom Kabbalat HaTorah, the day of receiving the Torah. That all the Sheva Shabbatot, all the 7 weeks that we're counting, right? 7 Saturdays, 7 Shabbases, complete one, the day of the counting, they are all preparing ourselves, right? This is like the greater preparation that we do. For the other Chagim, we don't need to prepare 50 days before the Chag. Right? Even Pesach, you clean. Okay, you can clean. It depends on how much you can clean. But if you clean minimalistic, like what you need, a day or two, and that's it, you're done. But here we have like preparation of 50 days. 50 days preparation, because it's not a joke. This is the day of the receiving the Torah. That's the core, right? Our foundation. And that preparation, the counting, again, it's we're going from one level to another. It's to purify us from our shells and from the impurity, and to refine and refine our souls from the filth. Liter mikol atumot. And only after that, we can have the Kedusha of Mala, and to arrive to the day of the Chag HaShavuot and receiving of the Torah. And the preparation starting in Pesach. Right? The preparation starting in Pesach, 50 days. And the beginning of it is Sur Merah. So the redemption from Egypt was to detach ourselves from the bad. Because again, when we left Egypt, we were not holy. But now we have the preparation of the counting and stepping each day a little bit higher and higher and higher until we're going out from the Tumah. And then we're going to be getting the Torah, receiving the Torah, and that fulfilling the purpose. And again, it's only the peak. So Pesach redemption was a peak. And then we went down. And then we started to climb up. And the peak again was Shavuot. But after Shavuot, there is another crash. It's always in wave. And now after we receive the Torah, we're crashing down metaphorically. And now we need to work, learn the Torah, do the mitzvot and everything, and then to climb up again and again. But our life should be like a healthy stock in the stock exchange. A healthy stock going up, and then it's going a little bit down, and then going up, and then a little bit down. But the trend is always climbing up. So this is how a Jew need to live in life. We cannot be perfect and climb all the time up. I wish we could, but it's not. So when we're going down a little bit, we need to remember how, when to stop and then to climb up again. So Bezrat Hashem, you know, getting to Shavuot, I wish that this year really Shavuot will have like a big surprise. I think it could be a very good timing for the Shavuot and to Mashiach to come in the same time. It would be like perfect. I think a perfect finale from Pesach to Shavuot and for this period of time in our life that never in the history we had such kind of a thing like the COVID. So I hope it was not just for nothing or for the mask industry to make more money. So Bezat Hashem, on Thursday we will continue, I think, the last part of the Sfirat HaOmer.